Welcome to the final edition of the Bones of Advertising for 2020. I've been Craig McLeod all the way through this journey, and you've been...
I've been a mixture of both John Douglas and excited. And I'm a little bit excited because it's been a great year to share with you, my friend. And it's Christmas.
And it's Christmas. Ho, ho, ho-dee-o, ho, my friend. So, yes, it is Christmas time. And look, it's been a fantastic journey. We kind of kicked this off back in March when things looked pretty ominous, that's for sure. And here we are, you know, in the midst of December.
Yep.
With a very different outlook, other than still a mask or two being worn around the place. But yeah, it's been a fantastic journey, and I've been very grateful to share it with you, my friend.
Indeed, it's been fantastic. It's it's one of those things that's just kind of evolved. If you go back to the very first episode, it was all a little bumpy. Well, bumpy back then, but we seem to have we've got through quite a few bones over the journey.
Is this 33 or 34? But anyway, whatever it is, it's testament to you and I and our, I guess, commitment to being able to talk shit for a very, very long time.
We have talked. I'm just going to adjust my screen just a little. I've had to move because COVID into the spare room.
Right.
I'm sharing an office again. I'm all over the place, but it's been an amazing year. Like, it's just been, we've gone through COVID. We've gone through two lockdowns. We've gone through, we've introduced guests. We've covered some pretty wide kind of area, and it's been a bit of a learning for both of us. You know, I think we've both kind of picked up a couple of things over the journey, which has been fantastic.
One of the things for me, I'm just blown away by how powerful the podcast is. There's an extraordinary number of podcasts out there.
That's usually my job, isn't it, to trip over.
No, I think I do a fairly good job of it as well, mate. But there's an extraordinary number of podcasts out there, and I think there's an extraordinary number that don't get listened to. But I think the power of the generation of content is so big, and what it does to everything else is enormous. So a prospective client, customer, or someone interested in whatever your topic of podcast is, can find out more about you and what you're all about in this kind of video format, although podcasts are obviously auditory, but we run a vlog as well. But they can have this audio process that they can attach themselves to if they're super interested. And it really does give them an insight into what you're all about, because, you know, we do edit our podcast to a certain extent, but pretty much most of it, all we do is edit out where we sound like dickheads. We try and remove the stuff where we're being fools or we're talking shit or I fumble my words. But ultimately, I guess what I'm saying is that the podcast itself is a really powerful tool, and something that I was surprised by how powerful it actually is. And I think if people can commit to it, and knowing you might be starting out with small numbers, but over the period of time, you know, that the growth in it can really start to grow over, you know, however long, 33 weeks. And I think our transition from, like you said, when we were early days and it was kind of you and I really sort of fumbling our way through what we were going to talk about, and sort of then picking up a bunch of topics and really finding our mojo to talk together about a specific topic in advertising and marketing, and then to switch over to bringing on guests, I feel was extraordinary learning curve for me. I absolutely loved it. And as I said before, I've enjoyed the experience with you extraordinarily. Like, I've really loved working so closely with you on a weekly basis. And I look forward to this time every day, every week.
Me too. I think all of our guests have been incredible. I think there's been an amazing amount of insight that we have been very privileged to share. I do like those episodes where we have just you and me disappeared down like 7,000 rabbit holes. We start out pretending to be really serious about, you know, about segmentation or targeting or or brand assets, and we end up talking about Jordan DeGoey
or Michael Jordan or something. Although I do love that. I mean, I love that it's this, you know, this trajectory of you and I off on an area, then all of a sudden we're over here, and it's been great. But yeah, I do agree. I think the guests have been a privilege, and I think that's kind of where I see, you know, we kind of elevated it a bit as well. You know, talking with Bobby Zagami or Paul Tucker or Beck Bryson, you know, like it's been amazing. Dave Rath, like I really have enjoyed that process. You know, Alicia McConnell, we've been so fortunate to be able to do that and get those insights from people and such a broad array of industries. You know, it was extraordinary for me to sit there and listen to all of them. And I reckon I've gained from them, if the audience hasn't, which is a bloody big bonus for me, mate. But as a segue, you do have somewhat of a very small stocking, which maybe could only house an iPad or an iPhone hanging behind you. But given it's Christmas, it would be remiss of us not to talk about the Christmas advertising campaigns that go on. And I know this is a favourite of yours, JD, and given the time of year, to not move ahead and talk about some of those Christmas advertising campaigns. You know, I've got three children and I'm a big Christmas man. I absolutely love Christmas. And you too have three children, a couple to the magical Mrs. Douglas and one from your trainer marriage.
Yes, indeed. Hello, Hannah. I know you'll be listening. Thank you. Hannah.
Yeah, but yeah, let's have a look at the Christmas advertising campaigns, my friend. What have you got to say?
I love this. I love every year. Like, so the Americans are very good at doing Super Bowl advertising. Like, that's kind of the big grand final.
We love that. And what was our favourite one this year? The Washington
Tide. Tide. It's a Tide ad. Yes. Yep. It was brilliant. It was just brilliant. But the every year the UK advertising they do a John Lewis started it really way back about probably 10 years ago. I mean they've always done this, but it's tears and it's laughter, tears and laughter. I mean, just watch any of those like Four Weddings and a Funeral or what's that one that they turn on every year where Liam Neeson, you know, and his kid with the drums, and you know, I Love Actually. Yeah. It's tears and laughter, tears and laughter, tears and laughter. It's a magic formula. The Aldi, the latest the Aldi one, the John Lewis one, I look forward to absolutely every year.
You saying Aldi locally with the Santas?
Well, they do a different one in
New York. So
they've got a
one. Yeah.
They've got a carrot, a hero carrot.
Right.
Watch it.
Yeah. Carrot.
Well, I'll put a link. We might tend to watch. We'll watch it now.
Look, a shooting star. It must be Christmas.
It's not Christmas till my daddy gets home.
Kevin the carrot was a long way from home. Would he spend Christmas all cold and alone?
Is it spring already?
No, it's Christmas, and I need to get home.
Ow! 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 Oh, dear!
Christmas without Kevin just wouldn't be the same. If he didn't return, how would Katie explain?
Kevin the Carrot? What are you doing here?
Santa.
Let's get you home. I've got an idea.
Wow. Ooh, hedgehog. Full moon tonight.
Daddy!
That magical moment was finally here. Christmas together with those you hold dear.
Great story, Santa.
Did I seem grumpy at the beginning?
Well, you can be a bit prickly. Merry Christmas, everyone.
Then we're back. But the John Lewis one every year. I tell you who actually has done there's two really good campaigns at the moment, and the Americans have decided that they're going to get in on the act. The Coca-Cola ad, which is just full of schmaltz.
Yeah,
right. There's very little laughter, and there's tears, and it's an adventure, and watch that. One is a really delightful look at what is important about Christmas.
Let's dance in style, let's dance for a while. Heaven can wait, we're only watching the skies. Hoping for the best, but expecting the worst. Are you gonna drop the bomb or not? Let us die young, or let us live forever. We don't have the power, but we never say never. Sitting in a sandpit, life is a short trip. The music's for the sad man. Can you imagine when this race is won? Turn our golden faces into the sun. Praising our leaders, we're getting in tune. The music's played by the madman. Forever young, I wanna be forever young. Do you really wanna live forever and ever and ever? Forever young, I wanna be forever young. Do you really wanna live forever and ever?
It's that whole kind of McDonald's recognizing that they're a family restaurant and then looking at family moments. And they're not saying, you know, have McDonald's for Christmas Day. Like, all that is like.
Well, I reckon my boy would love it.
Yes, and he wouldn't be the only one. It's just a delightful reminder that these brands have a place in our lives. And, I think they're worth watching. We'll do a couple back to back.
of all the things to be, I choose a kindness, and if you gave some to me, I think we'd find ourselves here dancing in the street. Everyone we meet would smile a little daydream. It could be amazing. Wouldn't it be wonderful if everybody gave a little
that whole idea that it's a great time to do a brand advertising rather than a retail. There's no retail component to it. There's no, we're here to sell you stuff. It's an awareness building. It's building another little place in an emotional part of your buying cycle that allows you to think more fondly of these people through the year. And we don't seem to do that in Australia as well as they do it overseas. And it may be a question of budget. It may just be a sense of, well, it's got to be effectiveness. Like if you do a Google search and you do, you know, great Australian Christmas ads, the top or the second top search result is most effective ads of most effective Australian Christmas ads. So I don't want it to be effective. I wanted to make me laugh and I wanted to make me cry.
That's exactly right.
If you're going to interrupt my viewing of being a Holiday Inn or White Christmas or being, you know, Miracle on 34th Street or something, I want to be crying. I want to be laughing.
You want to feel something, Jada. You want to get something. You want to feel something when you watch it.
Indeed. And it's worth the money that people spend. Like if you can get people absolutely emotionally responding to your communication and to your brand, then they will feel better about you over the course of the year. And it gives you a chance to actually start to make a profit on the stuff you're selling rather than just trying to get revenue in. So, yeah, that was back in episode 8, I believe.
A while back now, old episode 8. But I think that exactly what you're talking about stands true, and being really clear about, you know, the difference between doing brand and then trying to actually work on selling, you know, the understanding that you've got to have this baseline of brand. People have to know who you are without a doubt. And then you can work on your, you know, ability to work conversion as well.
Yeah, indeed. I think we need to be very careful about, you know, that whole sense of, now that I've got your attention, let me sell you something.
Yeah.
I think I think sometimes it's just nice to say, hey, thanks for buying our stuff this year and Merry Christmas. Like, you know, I don't think you need to be, I get the shits up a bit when people start doing that. Oh, you can't say Christmas, you've got to say festive season, and you know. Yep. And that seems to have gone a bit by the wayside. I think people are becoming a little bit more kind of, you know, sensible around that.
Yeah.
But essentially, it's just a celebration of community, isn't it? It's a celebration of family. It's the things that are, it's just a reminder of the things that are important. And this year especially, if you get to sit around a table with your nearest and dearest and say, could you just pass me some of those potatoes, please? Hey, you win. You know,
or a slice of turkey. Yep, exactly, mate. And you know, that's an extraordinary time of year this year. It will be an extraordinary time of year this year because of what we've been through. You've seen all those scenes of the news of people making their way back to states they've not been able to get into since March. So you imagine what Christmas is going to be like for some of those people that have been separated. I mean, you know, parents from children. It's extraordinary that's had to occur, but I think those Christmases and this Christmases will really herald in a different feeling and maybe even something different moving forward. I mean, I've noticed from an impact point of view, we're still seeing prospective clients on video. Now, you know, at the moment we could meet in a cafe, we could meet in, you know, in our office, we could meet, you know, somewhere else, but at the moment it's still the preferred mode of communication. Everyone's very comfortable with it. And I'm feeling like it might go on quite a lot into 2021. I mean, I'm sure there'll be times when we meet face-to-face, like I'm catching up with a media partner shortly and we'll do that face-to-face in a cafe. But I wonder when it will become the norm to jump in the car again, drive for 50 minutes, have a 45-minute meeting, drive back 50 minutes when you could jump on a call, you know, and talk for 45 minutes and do exactly the same thing. And you can get all of that effectiveness. Sorry, it was a segue away from Christmas, but I've just kind of thinking about how, you know, the changes at home will transition into the changes in the office. I know 25% of people can be back in the office in the CBD. I've noticed the roads more busy and our office sits right on Hampton Station. So I've noticed the station a bit busier as well in the mornings. I've been popping down to the office every now and then. But yeah, it'll be extraordinary. I'll be looking forward to seeing what's happening. That's what's going to happen, sorry, as we move into 2021.
I think it'll be, it'll be another adventure. And I think we're a little bit more open-hearted about what the possibilities could be. You know, I think people it's forced us to actually look at other ways of doing it. And hopefully that'll just, that'll segue very nicely into what people are prepared to do in terms of communication and branding, you know.
Yeah. And I think
getting back to the important things in life, advertising.
Yeah, exactly. And I think adaptability is another thing to take away from this year is, ability to, you know, refine and get leaner, take away all the periphery things that aren't required, and then potentially be able to prosper in an environment where it's not particularly easy to prosper. So, you know, that's really my outlook is how do you take this adverse situation, lean up a business, and then look at how you can really prosper in this particular space in a way that's going to work better from a life balance point of view from everyone within the business as well. I think the people that are working from home right now are very happy and very settled in that space. You know, we're thinking maybe a day a week in the office will connect and potentially if we have client meetings in the office, but I really do feel it's a different feeling from all of our people, all of our team members that, you know, they are a little less stressed. I think the drive and the commute has become, you know, a thing that they may not do very often anymore.
Yeah, I think there is a genuine recognition that offices are great for meetings and catching up with people and organising, but when it comes to productivity, there can be too many distractions in a lot of offices, and you need to. That balance with, I think this video, you know, the video capability and the conferencing capability has just allowed people to recognize that you don't need to have someone chained to a desk and be able to stare at them working just to be sure they're working. Because I think people actually like work. I think people actually, quite often, funnily enough, people like doing what they do. You know, it's odd. Anyway, Craig McLeod, have you got any parting thoughts for the year? Let, How would you, anything that you would like to, anything that you would like to just remember or pass on?
I think the parting thought for me is the world didn't stop and everything has really started to come back to a sort of normal. We're on our way back to normal, but I think it's try and be as courageous as you can while still keeping hold of the reins. So my parting thought for people, particularly people in business or people looking at advertising, you know, in perspective to what we do, it is know that your customers are still there in some way, shape or form. And depending on what industry you're in, think of 2021 as an opportunity and let's hope that things like vaccines are readily available very, very soon. But remember, it's time to say, let's move forward. And a lot of our clients are already talking about those sorts of things and already doing those sorts of things. But I think my parting thought would be glass half full, be optimistic about where we're headed. I mean, that's generally my philosophy on most things in business and in life is get ready for some fantastic stuff from us on the Bones in 2021. We've got some new and exciting plans that we'll be sharing with you about the Bones for 2021.
International guests.
Stop it.
International guests.
A whole bunch of stuff that we've got planned, which will be brilliant. And I think, as I said before, mate, I've had a ball doing it and really enjoyed spending the time with you. So my parting thought would be let's do more of it and keep extremely positive. What about you?
I am just going to be grateful for the privileges that we have, that we enjoy and that we have enjoyed and we continue to enjoy.
Yeah.
You know, it's been a privilege to share this time for you this time with you every Friday. I'm very, very grateful for that. I'm grateful for still having my nearest and dearest around me. You know, the family we've got through it all and, you know, we still like each other. We live in a country where there's like there were 100,000, there's millions of people dying.
Yes.
And getting infected around the world.
Yep.
And we live in a country where we're largely untouched by it, which is a privilege, and I'm incredibly grateful for that. So I'm going to leave this year with an immense amount of gratitude. I know it's been tough for a lot of people, but I have had some. I've had a very, very good year. I've connected with some fantastic people, and I look forward to doing some very interesting and rewarding things in the new year. And I especially look forward to spending a little bit more time with you, my friend.
Well, that's brilliant. Thank you, mate. And
I salute you, Craig McLeod. What a year it's been.
Another edition of the Bones of Advertising wrapped up, JD. It's going to be a while, but don't go changing, and I'll see you on the other side.
You will. You will. The other side's right there. It's just around the corner.
Right there.
Take care, mate.
Merry Christmas, everyone.
Merry Christmas.